Can you hear me?
You look wonderful. You sound wonderful. Okay. Martina. Hello.
Hi. Can you hear me?
You look wonderful. What else could it be? Robert C. Ford. How are you?
Wall Street poet reporting for duty. I am ready to go. Am I first, last, or next week?
A little loud. You're getting distorted. And I think if you go to preferences and you check your audio, maybe the microphone volume is a little too high.
I will adjust that down a little bit.
Sound better.
Yeah.
All right.
Okay.
You guys chat, Peter and Kat?
Yes. Excuse me?
I put a message in the chat for you guys.
Oh, okay. Hang on.
I can send you the link right now. Just a second.
Cool. Put it in the chat. Thank you.
Of course. You're welcome.
All right. Thomas, how are you?
Me?
Yeah.
I'm good. How are you?
Subalaro. There you are. You're ready.
Yeah.
You're a Zoom pro. I could count on you.
Yeah. And just really quick, we get 4 minutes, right?
3 to 4 minutes. Yes.
Okay. Perfect. All right.
We're supposed to read our poem that's in the magazine, right?
Yes, definitely read that. And if you have some time, something else on the theme of humanity, the reboot.
Right.
Something that exemplifies that.
Okay. All right.
John Trous is joining.
Okay. And Gordon, I'll admit him. And Steve Dalachinsky is Yukon. And David Lawton.
I don't know them. David Lawton, yes, I'm admitting, sorry.
Mm-hmm. I'm not sure who Mac User is.
Mm-mm.
We'll wait for them.
Okay.
Because I think we have everybody here.
Where's
15, we're shy one.
Jody?
We're shy. Blickley.
Maybe that's Blickley.
Maybe. All right. So, hey, John G. Trous, how are you? Take yourself off mute so we can hear you.
I'm good. How are you?
You sound great. You look great. Thank you.
Thank you.
Yuko, how you doing? Yuko?
Okay. Yes.
Okay, you're kind of frozen, but I can't see you moving. Can you like move around? Okay. Maybe something's going wrong there. Did we get Jane back? She's trying again.
She's trying to join us, but she always like something is with the connection. She leaves us and then rejoins. So I don't know.
There's Yuko. Okay, great. You're moving, Yuko. Let's hear you talk.
Can you hear me?
Yes. Now we hear you. Very good.
Speaking. Oh, you're a little frozen. You know.
Yeah.
So, yeah.
Maybe you're weak on your
signal.
Your signal.
All right.
You may want to try logging in again.
Yeah.
Try logging in again. Okay. David Lawton, how are you? Lawton, take yourself off.
Mute. Yeah, it'd be cool to do a high.
I was saying testing, and I had it on mute.
All right. Okay, so Gordon, how are you?
I don't know if Gordon's there or where.
Gordon is there, but he's on mute.
Still connecting.
We can't see you.
He's waiting to connect. So everybody's looking good.
Haida.
Jane, you're back.
Hey. Is that better?
I think you look a little better.
You look good.
Okay, good.
You're better. You sound better. There's Haida.
Are you in Hudson, Jane?
No, I'm in the city at the moment.
I was going to say, if you have any problems, come over.
Okay. Gordon Gilbert, what are you doing? Robbing a safe? You look like you're like in a room. It's dark. There he is.
There you are.
All right, Gordon, how do you sound? Let's hear you.
Testing, 1, 2, 3.
Very good. Hiya, how are you?
How are you?
Very good to see you.
We changed our whole program, and I would like to test if it works, if the sound works. Can I test that now? In addition to my speaking.
Oh, are you going to have sound too? Okay, test it out right now. We've got 1 minute.
Okay.
You keep saying.
Could you hear that?
Yeah.
Okay.
It's a little loud, but we
yeah, make it a little lower.
Oh, okay, good.
You'll listen to me.
Right. Like that.
Oh, a little louder.
Perfect.
Good.
A little louder. Yeah. That's it.
Okay.
Good, Haida.
But okay. Speak. It's gonna go in and out because
she's not speaking. She's not speaking. That's the sound for her piece.
Oh, perfect. Okay. Great. Okay. All right.
Peter, a cat, everyone knows the order. Yes? Who goes after who?
No, I don't know.
No,
is it alphabetical?
Yeah, so we're going to turn off, we're going to put everybody on mute. And then when you, I'm going to read through the order right now. So just remember who's before you.
And is there a way you could just put it in the chat? Like if you have it on screen, cut it and just put it in the chat and then we can see it there?
Great idea, Jane, but no, we can't because it's on.
Okay. Got it.
Okay, just say it.
It's in order.
All you gotta do is remember one name. Who's before you? That's it. So here we go. From the top, Peter will read the introduction. Then Joel Allegretti, Mark Blickley.
I don't know where he is though.
Robert C. Ford, Thomas Fucolaro, Joanna Furman,
Gordon Gilbert, John S. Hall, Bibby Hansen, Haida Hatry, Ron Combe, Eleni Courtney, David Lawton, Jane LaCroix, Elliot Markbine, Jane Omerod, Yuko Otomo, Martina Salisbury, Christine Sloan Stoddard, John J. Trouse, Thomas Walker.
Do we have John J. Trouse here?
Everybody's okay. Here, but I didn't see
Blick. I'm here.
Okay.
I don't know if he's a Mac user.
I asked him if he's participated in the show, but didn't respond. Okay.
All right.
So I don't see him.
Who, John J. Trouse?
No, Mark Blickley. Okay, let's let everybody in.
Okay. Good luck, everyone.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
Da 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 da. Okay. To look at this one. Everybody's on mute. No, everybody's not on mute.
Uh-oh, we're going to be live soon.
I know. Okay. There he is, Blick.
He's there?
Yeah.
Just let him blink.
Mark, can you hear us?
Where is he?
You need to unmute.
To unmute. Yeah, can you hear me?
You look good. We're ready to go.
Okay, you're second. After Joel Allegretti. So Peter will read the intro, and then Joel, and then Mark. Here we go.
All right. See you. See you on the other side, everybody.
Okay. So let's start. Just a second. Three more people to admit, and we're starting. So I'm super excited to announce that today is our second day of the Dada Festival. After the first one, guys, you boosted me with so much energy that I was dancing, I was singing the whole evening and the next day. So I really hope today the same thing will happen. So please try your best and let's have as much fun as we can. Peter, Kat, please.
All right.
We're going to have fun. Here we are. I'm Peter Carlaftes. This is Kat Georges. And we are the plagiarists.
Plagiarists.
We stole everything. We stole from the last plague and we brought it along with us now. We're plagiarists.
Right.
And we published MAINTENANT 15. We actually have books in the house for the first time since July. It's insane.
It's beautiful.
You don't want to know this story, but it's a beautiful copy. Who did this cover art, Kay?
Oh, why? That cover was done by Edel Rodriguez, a Cuban American whose work has appeared on the cover of Time Magazine
and
all over the place. Check him out. He's online on many social medias. It's a beautiful cover.
Side Effects, it's called.
Right.
So.
And this book is available at the New York Public Library to check out and also from Three Rivers Press if you want to purchase your own copy.
Yes. And we are Dada. Dada, Dada, Dada. But if we don't have to explain ourselves, we don't have to tell you anything, and that's Dada enough as it is, right?
Right.
But Kat will say something about Dada. What you we believe go ahead. In. Well, what we've always felt is the anti-war sentiment of Dada. There were, you know, a whole continent there just staring at trenches filling with corpses. And they said, if the beauty of the world has brought us to this place, the world has to change.
That's right, so Pete.
We are proponents of that thought right there. And that's what we carry on today with all of our contemporary contributors. So let's get into that sentiment. Our theme for this number 15 is humanity.
The reboot.
The reboot. So it's time to reboot after a year on the dole, a year in the pen, a year wherever we've been. Now it's another year going on. We've got to. What's happening? We got to mute. Mute.
Mute all. Right.
Good, good, good. Excellent. So I'm going to read the
introduction,
which will start us off into this wonderful foray with the NYPL. And thank you, Aliana. So humanity to reboot. Reboot humanity.
Ha!
Ha! She said ha. Ha!
Ha!
Okay, with irreversible climate change, bottomless inequality, blatant warmongering,
self-obsessed authoritarianism,
and widespread pandemic.
Who needs the same world now?
Who needs the same old world? The Beckett quote, fail better, may have held some significance in the latter stage of the last century, but at this terminus of existence, it would be impossible for humanity to fail any better. This pinnacle of failure is ours to behold, and we must celebrate.
As we do here,
by creating that which fully reveals the extent of ruin humanity has inflicted upon our planet. Now, we fail best. All right. So we've got 243 contributors in here from 31 countries.
Around the globe.
And
every continent except Antarctica.
Next year we've got Antarctica. So we're going to have every continent next year. But this year, what we have now is the New York Public Library is sponsoring today's reading performance. And we have all of our New York contributors here with us today, or half. We had the other half last week. So let's start off with contributor number one, reader number one, performer number one, Joel Allegretti. Speak up, Joel.
Turn off your mute.
Thank you, Kat and Peter. Good evening, everybody. First, I want to offer thanks and kudos to Kat and Peter for including me in another beautiful issue of MAINTENANT. I always look forward to every year's issue. They get me thinking in ways that I otherwise wouldn't think, such as this year's issue. It's a piece of text art. Democracy allows us to choose fascism. And for my second piece, I'll go to last year's issue of MAINTENANT, which carried the theme unsustainable SH*T. The history of Japanese movie monsters, King Ghidorah, originally Kingu Ghidorah. Care for this planet as if you fear a three-headed space dragon will come down to torment the human race in retaliation for neglect. Thank you.
Exciting. We've got the whole
so
city.
So excited to have Joel Allegretti.
So thank you, Joel. And now we're going to move on to the next reader, are we?
Yes.
The next performer.
The next
Mark
performer.
Mark Blickley. Please, Mark,
please
bring yourself
welcome
up
Mark
and,
Blickley.
And comport yourself.
There he is.
I comport myself accordingly. All right. I'm going to read an Afracris collaboration I did with Amy Basson. And I think we've had collaborations since MAINTENANT 9, and the photo that's in this issue was actually kind of historic for me, because it was taken on the Saturday after the election, I was in Greenwood Cemetery, which is my favorite spot in all of New York City to hang. And while we were there, everybody started shouting. It was like the dead came alive. People were shouting. And that's when the Biden results were in. So I was there with an artist and another poet. And Amy took a picture of poet Mark Donnelly coming down a hill. And based on this picture, I came up with this text called Pandemic Prophet. Okay. Proud paleo perfect people, come forth and purify yourselves in our annual pageant of truth, the DOA Dervish. Help squeeze the pus out of the pimple of humanity's darkest time, the dawn of agriculture, when we were forced from our true nature of hunter-gatherer into the curse of sagging and shapeless humankind that does not want us to venerate and expose the powerful purity of uncontaminated genes, free of chemical additives and crop failure famine. Flabby factory farming has stripped us of our true PPPP heritage. Dance to resist this molestation of grain growing and incestuous ranch animal husbandry. Dervish away the putrid DOA domesticated abomination of that very first dawn of agriculture 13,763 years ago. Better dead than bread. Homeostasis in the highest. Praise be to the Lord and all other natural byproducts. Thank you.
Mark, very good. All right.
All right,
thank
Mark.
You, Mark from MAINTENANT 15, Mark Blickley. Excellent. Yes, we remember that day too. We were on the roof right above our head here dancing with Jane and Pete. So it was a wonderful day. It was, I think, November 7th, if I'm not mistaken, of last year. And and we're coming up on that day now, another 1 year to celebrate. Anyhow, let's move along. We're going to have our next performer, and that is Robert C. Ford from downtown from here.
All right, take away
Robert C. Ford, the downtown poet.
Good evening from Wall Street. So my Dada contribution this year is called The Biggest Lie, Trickle Down. It doesn't require much explanation. It's very in your face. So a fun fact is my composer, musician friend, Gene Pritzker, who is the lead orchestrator for the Matrix 4 coming out in December. A little plug for him there. He set it to hard rock music, which I'll sample at the very end. So that was quite an honor. Okay, biggest lie, trickle down. Jeff Bezos, one man, $200 billion, lifetime earnings at $7.50 an hour for 300,000 people. When blessed with abundance, the rich simply build bigger castles further from Main Street. The rich complain of luxury, the poor dream of necessity. The invisible hand only promotes inequality. Trickle down, come on now. They say it's raining, but my cup is empty. Trickle down, come on now. That's not champagne. Stop pissing on me. Jobs replaced by technology. A homeless man reads Dostoevsky. Raskolnikov didn't kill pawnbroker. Old woman was killed by society. When all the game pieces are held by a few, it's time to topple the ivory tower. Minnows don't feast on sharks. Let's supply the little guys with fishing rods. Control, Alt, Delete. Thank you, Kat and Peter.
Thank All you, right. Robert C. Ford.
Thank you,
the
Robert
downtown
C.
poet.
Ford.
All right, excellent.
All
excellent.
The way from Wall Street.
He's done I'll that. See you next year, hopefully in person.
Yeah, yeah. All next right. year in person, definitely. Yeah. Right there with Aliana. We're going to be standing next to Aliana.
All right.
So next we have heavy male centric right now, but we're 10 and 10 tonight. 10 men, 10 women, 11, including Kat, 11, including me. Okay. But we're 10 and 10. The first four are men alphabetically. So all that right. counts for six. And then how many more women? So don't worry. Okay. We've got Thomas Fucoloro. Come Take on, baby. Ready, Get Thomas. Up there. Knock him dead.
All right, I'm going to start. I have two poems. I'm going to start with the poem in the book. Rosemary's sandwich. What have you done to its sides? It's going to be a very special sandwich. You have to be thinly sliced to get in. Oh, and you'll make it all right. You can be the knife. You're trying to get into my digestive system. Well, it's a sandwich. They have moistened the bread. What are you talking about? I always leave the bread dry. What have you done, you maniacs? What we bite is never as good as what we swallow. And the limitations of what we can stomach is never as noble as what passes through us. We're fertile, all right. I've got 20 milligrams of Imodium AD to prove it. The food critics will say this sandwich represents reproduction represented as monstrous digestion. This psychological horror of always trying to take a bite out of something and put it on film. Okay, and I just have one more poem for you all. Thank you for listening to the obnoxious yelling and screaming at the screen. Aunt Pearl's ceramic off-pink starfish. How you regaled us, story abound, story entrusted, encrusted on thee. To Aunt Pearl's ceramic off-pink starfish, how you used it to battle the Nazis in World War II like a superhero possessed. My Aunt Pearl would weaponize, throw, penetrate, permeate in the name of. The piano, a soft hum, echoes piercing flesh. To Aunt Pearl's ceramic off-pink starfish, how I played with you when younger and other worn-out ceramic things on your shelves, like books. I never had to look up to the stars. For that moment, I let go of the stars within my grasp. Hand it to age, time cries, another worn-out spirit gone. We said goodbye to Aunt Pearl, but Aunt Pearl's ceramic off-pink starfish lives on. Until Uncle Danny sold it at a yard sale to the Hendersons. And you can see it through their window on their bookcase, wearing a drooping watch, two rings, and a whole lot of rubber bands. Aunt Pearl's ceramic off-pink starfish isn't dead, but it's dying of someone else's banality. They must be stopped. At Target, I purchased this ceramic and silver-plated octopus, purple in shape with the tentacles edged. It's not what you save, but how you look foolish saving it. I ring their bell. Thank you.
Wow.
All right, Thomas.
Beautiful. Amazing. That's right. Whoa.
Okay, way yeah. to go. Thank you, Thomas Fugoloro.
Oh my God.
And here's M15, MAINTENANT, Humanity, the Reboot. We've got another issue coming up. Our submission period will start on January 1st. We've moved it, pushed it back a little, a month and a half or whatever. What was it? A month and a half, correct?
Right.
We started, no, two and a half.
Two months.
So, 2 months.
Yeah.
So we want to start in the new year because we want new thoughts and we're still working on the theme. I have come up with a theme that we're still fighting over, but I don't think it's going to work, but we like it. Net zero. What do you think?
All right.
It's not against the Russians. They got enough problems. It means, what are we doing with our life? We're not going anywhere. Net zero. That's what the net zero is. Okay. Let's bring up Joanna Furman. She's Yay! The next reader. Yay, Joanna.
Hi. I'm going to read the prose poem that was in the issue. It's page 79, if you're reading along. The year the internet was a glitching map. To the west, an ocean of hand sanitizer convulsing in waves, a mountain of rhinestones plucked from the foreheads of dead flaneurs. To the east, holograms of the Bee Gees, wiggling in sequenced masks, an American flag wrapping itself around a vat of bleeding meat, a neon sign flickering, untranslatable. To the south, a flashlight that shines on an open palm, revealing the future of the president everyone should hate. A marshmallow shaped like a finger jamming the hole in a busted dam. A baby in work boots digging a hole. Another baby hoarding diapers in preparation for a rumored war. To the north, a Valentine covering the face of the Confederate general. A kombucha river scented with whiskey and wine. At the center is me, an empty bottle full of honking. A compass rose in the shape of a fist. And I'll also read another like little tiny poem. This is called Love Poem in a Failed State. Some mornings when I'm just a typo in pajamas and the rain is the thick black eyeliner around an unseen sun. The glimpse of your left eye opening under the blankets is enough of a welcome to flip the bird to despair, to allow myself to feel each one of my fingers wiggling itself awake. Thank you.
Yay, Johanna Furman.
Thank you, Joanna. That very was nice. Great.
Wonderful.
Okay, we're moving along here.
Yeah, we're moving through the list, and we're again, I'm Kat Georges, Peter.
And we are the plagiarist. We've stolen all the germs, and we've recreated them under our own name, the plagiarists.
Yeah.
We've done it.
All right. Who's next, Peter?
We have Gordon Gilbert. Please welcome. He's a few blocks away, I think.
There he is, Gordon.
Here I am. All right. Thank you, Peter. Thank you, Kat. I love the fact that you're doing this every year. And thanks for including my poem. The first one is the poem that's in MAINTENANT 15, the second one, a short one, of the same nature. The golden calf. He spoke appropriately enough, although misspoken, of a herd mentality. He could have been speaking of his own followers, this super spreader, deliberately infecting their bodies and their minds. Now they wander in a desert of their own making, mindless in their worship of this golden orange-coiffed calf. And at his bidding, they have set aside the Ten Commandments for only one that now all must obey. Bow down and worship me. But in their midst, in fear of all the others, some silent unbelievers still look in desperation up the mountain, praying for deliverance from this idol, as hopeful they await another Moses. For some reason, I'm just getting the two of you on the speaker screen. Is that weird? Can you hear me okay? I can't hear you at all, but that's fine. You're muted. Okay. Well, I don't mind looking at the two of you big on the screen while I'm reading. Only a reflection. All smoke and mirrors, that's all he is, a cliche, sad but true. Finding affirmation of his own existence only in a reflection in the eyes of others. But when eyes look away or close and backs are turned, he finds no mirrors left to preen and strut before. And were he capable of introspection, he would find no substance, no vital core, all melted away to nothing, nothing more than smoke that dissipates. Let it be so. It is what we devoutly hope for. His moment come and gone, it cannot be too soon. Oh, It will come, and then this man we can and will choose to ignore, and in time, we hope, forget. Thank you. Thank you, Peter and Kat.
Hey, thank you, Gordon. All right. That was Gordon Gilbert.
Yes, it was. Gilbert. And Gordon, people are saying if you go to the top right corner of your screen that says view, go to gallery view. And if you go stage left or to the top of the right there, either way, right up there. So you can see everybody then. And you know, it's fun to see. Well, we love looking at everybody. And next, coming up, John S. Hall. Take it away.
Hi, everybody. Yes, I am John S. Hall. Here is the poem that I wrote for Maintenant, and then I'll do another one. Take two for Marcel Puke. Rebooting. Isn't booting a euphemism for throwing up? Have we been thrown up, re-ingested, and then rebooted? Are we better off just getting the boot? When the rioting starts, who makes off with the loot? When the party is thrown, will you wear a zoot suit? Rudy, toot, toot, three men and a flute, tooting and pooting and pouting and shouting and shitting and knitting and kneading and pleading and plowing and sewing and knowing that our days are numbered, regretting all the ways we slumbered when we ought to have thundered, now inebriated and encumbered, pickled, impossible to be re-cucumbered. We have bumbled, fumbled, stumbled, and shut down. We await rebooting, reshooting what was overexposed. We'll fix it in post or we're toast. And then I just found out that I could do another one. So every day I try to write three poems and post them to Facebook. You know, if you want to check that out, I put the URL in the chat. So I will post this one tomorrow. I just wrote it right before we went on. It's poem number 1084 for the year, and it's Reboot. By way of explanation, Marcel Puke was the pseudonym of Michael Wisniewski, who was best known by another pseudonym, Winchester Chimes. Chimes was a surrealist and Dadaist poet, singer, songwriter, painter, playwright, and performance artist who died of AIDS in 1990. And I thought of him not just because he was a Dadaist, but because the word boot is sometimes used to mean puke. I suppose that is rather attenuated, but there it is. And I was told about a half hour ago that if I finish my reading of Take Two for Marcel Puke in less than 4 minutes, I can use the remainder of the time to read something else on the topic of humanity, the reboot. So here I am rebooting again, rebooting, because when I see you, darling, it's like we both are falling in love again. It'll be just like starting over. But if this had been an actual reboot, my computer would be telling me to please wait, please wait. Please wait, and I would just have to wait, just like I'm doing right now, just waiting for another idea. So if boot means to puke, then in order to reboot, you would have to eat your own puke and then puke it again, and that sounds inhuman to me. I've seen dogs eat their own puke, but never a human. I suppose it has happened, but I have never seen it. So humanity, the reboot, is a lovely idea, unless it means that humanity is puking and then eating its puke and then repuking its puke. So I hope that isn't what it means. Thank you.
That's a legitimate concern there, John S. Hall. Legitimate concern, John S. Hall.
John S. Hall.
Way to go, beautiful.
All right, so happy he can be with us.
Yes.
I'm glad you could join us. All right,
Maintenant 15. We are going to bring up one of our luminaries. Please welcome to the screen, the stage, Bibby Hansen. Here she comes. Hey, Bibby,
turn off mute.
You're on mute. Hey.
Thanks for letting me come and play another year. This is such a blast. I enjoy it so much. So we're humanity, the reboot. I have a couple of reboot poems. And then the picture for this year was boots. That's a backstage picture. The yellow ones are Matt from Cage the Elephant. The pink ones are my son, Bex. And then the black ones are my husband, Sean. Okay, so the poem is very, these are very shorty poems. Reopen the app for giving living another try. Lying inside the riddle of a piddle puzzle, you nuzzle hope, pushing at the pieces, burying the feces like the neatest OCD cat. That was that one. And they're little shorties, just like me, because I'm a little shorty. Okay, never enough is too much to grow or know. Are we flower or weed? What is your need? Teed off with the petty lack or heady knack? Rolling through midline meadows? Hay fever nightmares are rare in subarctic pulling pole in dead zones. Will your boner for life remain rife with a new tomorrow? So that just happened to be a poem named Reboot. And then I have another one, another shorty that I wrote for my dear friend, Simone Gadd, who died this year. She's a great artist, great actress, wonderful performer and poet, writer. Reboot. Just heard that you have died. No more are you she, but perhaps to be some future thing else, other than the you I knew. And my life is new now too, without you anymore in it. Oh, but oh my darling, oh my dear, just how do I begin it? To Simone.
Thank you, baby. Oh,
baby, that was beautiful. Thank you so much. All
right. Thank you. That was wonderful.
Beautiful. Thank you so much for joining us. And I liked your line. It came together, forgiving living.
Yeah.
I like that. It's something that a lot of us cannot do.
Right.
Anyhow, MAINTENANT 15. Let's move along the roster. Who are we bringing up next to this? To the lovely screen will be Haida Hatry. Please welcome Haida.
She's going to unmute, and here she is.
Yay. Unmute.
Beautiful.
Okay. It's all about rebooting. Start walking. reboot humanity.
All right, beautiful, Haida. Haida. Wonderful performance. Thank you so much.
All right, Haida.
A great performance.
Yeah.
These reboots are made for walking.
I think after that, we should show everybody and briefly have you turn off your mute off for a second. And let's give everybody in this first half a round of applause.
Yay.
Yay.
Yay. Yay.
Now we're gonna mute y'all again, and we're gonna get
she
on.
She likes that.
That's not a power trip. Don't worry.
But we are the plagiarists, and we are here with the same plague. So don't worry. And that plague is once a year, MAINTENANT 15, and it is a plague for humanity.
Yes.
Not to reboot the same way, but to continue to grow, to continue to find ways to connect and belong.
Right.
That's what we're about. So,
All right.
Let's move on to.
Now, who do we have next?
I'm not sure. Ron Cohn. I see the name. Ron Cohn is coming onto the screen right
Please
now.
Please welcome to the stage, Ron Cohn.
How the hell do I follow that? That's impossible. I have to go to the bathroom or something. Anyway, thank you, Peter and Kat. And thank you, Aliana from the library too. She's terrific. They're building an archive there of East Village literature. She's terrific. Anyway, from MAINTENANT, the plastic factory redux. Agar and Algin, the plaque broom twins, are dying to live in a better world, but this one won't let them go. They toss another load into the autoclave, cackling hysterically as they bless it with a static eliminator. Algin, lit by the factory's overhead lights, tries to commit a complicated equation to memory while Agar gives him a thumbs up. They amble off the floor, heading to the cafeteria as black eels escape from the pockets of their coveralls. And then one short one from the old Welcome to the Barbecue book, what can I tell you? Make love, not war. Knowing that one can love and perhaps be loved in return, it seems a miracle to me that men still fly over mountains to kill. Thank you so much, everyone. Let's hope there's a better world around the corner.
Thank you, Ron.
Thanks for joining us, Ron. It's always wonderful to have you with us. So thanks.
To the best.
MAINTENANT 15 is always great to have everybody we have had on tonight. Yeah, last time, we've also got a in November, we've got four shows coming up in our own Dada Festival with, I think it's 34 and 24. So that's what, 56 readers and four different shows, going to be incredible. But right tonight is incredible as we're here. Just want to mention that we're going to continue seeing everybody in the book and bringing the book to life and bringing us closer together. So who do we have next? Eleni Korte.
All
so
please welcome
Elodie. Hi. I'll do two. I'll do the MAINTENANT contribution and I'll do the one more. So, nymphs and dicks. I'm not a Christian or any other. I just believe in the spirits of the woods. Though the woods are gone, is the moment to really believe in them. Though the springs are polluted, the nymphs could still reappear dancing at riverbanks. Though the ocean is consumed by plastic, I believe in mermaids. It's the moment to believe. Not to some old man in the sky or prophet or any other similar contraption or any man from above or any man. I do believe in satyrs though, running down the now barren hills. Thank God there's still some dicks around. And the next one, it's called At the Cafe, yesterday. I am looking at a nerd and a sinister fuck. They're talking about branding. They're deciding my future. I guess the same assholes that branded cows in the West and became cowboy heroes in movies, these two guys will be heroes in a future video game. The heroes that branded humanity and now know who you are. Save the rest of us from evil. Now you know who everyone is and scream pointing your finger soon she's taken away. What if death is no relief? Should I attack these two as they speak in the cafe? I am scared. What if you can't find freedom even in death? I want out of technology. I can hear you.
Thank you, Eleni.
Excellent, excellent.
All right.
Wonderful. She's right. Fantastic. She's right.
Okay.
All right. So we're going to just move along. MAINTENANT 15. You can get a copy somewhere. Get it at the library if you like.
Yes.
But you can buy one from us. Buy one online. Every outlet, any store you might go into may have this, or you can order it from that store.
Right.
So we would love to see you have this book.
Who's next?
I'm not sure who's next. Let's look over here. Hey, It's David Lawton. Come on, David.
Hey, I'm being told my internet is unstable, but I figure in this reading, if I break up or I get knocked off, that's very Dada. Mellow conversation with myself after Miguel de Cervantes, sort of. We suffer and endure, dividing ourselves. Time shifts gear from speeding away from us to ceasing to have meaning altogether. Do you have meaning altogether? Does meaning have time for me? This kind of existential contemplation is intellectually exhausting. It makes my brain dribble like cottage cheese. It's a challenge in itself to speak in full sentences, to tell each other about our lives, find out why we settle into certain patterns, how we fall for the same shit all the time, when we are so extraordinary, one of a kind, destined for greatness. Mother always said so, said you were special. Well, she didn't say it out loud. There are so many kids, it would have been rude. And we don't go for rudeness at our house. We promised ourselves many times to be a good person. That's all it's about. If you accomplish that, you have everything. There is nothing else you need. No room for anyone else except myself. For me, I've a donkey worth a dozen. A door key? A beast of burden, something to give one purpose. Milder tasks deliver me dazzled right here. So why bother looking for the cake you were promised? Out mode. My old boss, Mr. Scratch, failed to shut down his computer in his basement study circa 1989. It had an old dial-up modem, and that screeching signal used to send a shiver up his spine working all alone down there, so he never had gone back. Now the hard drive is petrified. The database fields are calcified. There's groundwater backwash which has seeped inside the screen, illuminating ghosts in the machine. Scratch tried a manual shutdown, held the button in place until it hurt his hand, unplugged the power from the wall socket. It stayed as undead as it already had, but grunted and groaned, an inner grinded processing of forgotten information through outmoded, so abandoned lines across a present not as modern as we'd like, to a future we can't hope to be upgraded for.
David Lawton.
Wow. All right.
All the way uptown there. And
And speaking of uptown.
Oh, uptown girl, our uptown girl, Jane LaCroix is next. So please take it away, Jane, and
wish her well.
And we wish you all the best.
So you guys can hear me. You could see me. Closer, closer. My mouth, my nose, my eyes. What are you made of? Is it just your body? What is your mind anyway? Do you mind? I'm going to tell you about the future now. But first, because you get to see me advertise maintenant in my bikini, I am going to give you a bikini reading. It's not false advertising. To thrill you.
Yay!
I'll let down my hair.
Jane, you're muted.
All right, now you can hear me. The future. We are the robots in the future. Perfect, free of death, no hunger, no thirst, free to choose our bodies, tweak our genes, pick our traits, indomitable strength and capability, downloading history, information, all knowing, constant communication, instant mass broadcast, defying age. In 2019, the first black hole was captured and multiplied on newspapers all over the world. We wonder about the time machine and if it could help us. The black hole is the time machine. We have access to and use the newspaper. Over and over, we choose to erase it, undo it, reject it. And this is our loop. We fail to improve anything despite the power we have. When we are perfect in the future as robots, existence becomes meaningless because without imperfection, we have no desire. Nothing matters when everything is perfect. We long for meaning, right, David Lawton? So we decide to make things matter by erasing the time machine. Returning to the consequences of random chance, making the black hole seem far away instead of right here in the newspaper. The thing about time machines and the black hole being accessible and the robots taking over is it's all true. It's already happened. And that, yes, the robots take over. We are the robots, the satellites and signals. That's us marching to the future, making the future. Look at what technology has made possible. We finally have new problems now. And now I'm just going to read one short one. To the light. This one's like more positive. Whatever it takes to keep you wearing the light so your darkness can be your garment to don at the ball of days. Tie it on with the help of the ones you love, your witnesses, your partners, your guests at the party of time. Kiss their mouths, touch their bodies, make them feel so you may feel the turning wheel of the planet in its choreography by the sun. That pierces your body and mind, making you new over and over, always.
Thank you, Jay LaCroix.
The flavorous kiss you back. We give you nose kisses. Where are we? Yay, we gotta get up there, Kay. Hey, yeah, the flavorist, thank you, with all their warm. Wishes.
Right. So I'm going to read a piece that
Cat's is going next.
From one of our international contributors to MAINTENANT. And this is from Matthias Jansson, who's from Sweden. Your planet ran into a problem and needs to restart. We're just collecting some error info and then we'll restart for you. Error, bad environment. Error, earth full. Error, too many people. Error, not enough food. error, empathy not found, error, insufficient insight, error, invalid leaders, error, out of solutions. Configuring planet updates, 1% complete. Do not turn off your planet. Please contact the application support team for more information. Thank you. All right.
Thank you, Pat George. Yeah. Pat George is right here next to me. Reads
and
from
Matthias Jensen.
Jensen in Sweden. I think he'll be on the show in November. He'll be performing with us. So all right. Be nice. I think so.
Yeah. So who is next here?
Next we have Elliot Markbine.
Okay.
Hi, everyone. It's really nice to meet everybody, to see faces, to words. And thank you, Peter and Kat, for putting this event together. It's really amazing. My piece in Maintenant 15 is called Poisson Rouge, and it's a collage. And this one here, right here. And I am going to read just a little bit of prose that I wrote that is sort of connected to it. But I did make a video about the collage, and I think, Peter, you said you were going to post it on the website. I'm not sure whether it is or not. What I'm going to read tonight is called Remember. Remember, love, the three cherry trees in Central Park, north of the Belvedere Castle, you know, between the lake and the path. Yeah, right there. Remember how kids and grown-ups used to climb their branches each year in July and August, us among the wild ones, to gorge ourselves on their cherries? They were the red kind, stains and all. Then one day, they were cut down. No warning, no fanfare, just sadness and total disbelief. Oh, and do you remember how the badgers and the raccoons used to reclaim Fifth Avenue in the wee hours of the night, strolling and foraging en famille, chasing after each other's, their round fluff bobbing up and down the avenue, meanwhile eradicating the rat population, probably the best sanitation and pest control the city ever had. Well, in time, they were declared a nuisance and swiftly dealt with. Can you recall, love, the taste of linden tea? Homemade with linden flowers, we used to harvest late May along Riverside Drive, when the air stirred with their honey and vanilla fragrance, the sweetness of it all. Remember? Remember the welfare hospital on Roosevelt Island before the Cornell Tech campus sprang up in its place? Each room with direct sunlight and a balcony, a place in waiting for many of their severely disabled patients. Remember how the staff used to roll out residents on their beds in early April so they could rest under the blooming cherry trees? The humanity in this still chokes me years later and lodged the seed of cautious optimism in me. Will the seed, though, ever germinate? Will you one day, love, lounge in a lush meadow amid trees and brilliant flowers where once Times Square stood, while cows graze on gentle hills and Poisson Rouge peruses the encyclopedia, all the while keeping an eye on the TV screen? Will you, love? Thank you.
Elliot Markbine, a beautiful memory there that you brought to life, very evocative of of what you experienced and what the city experienced and what is no longer here. No way to reboot that except through you. So we're very
hopefully we can get back to some of that.
It's possible. Only when human beings are gone will there be these animals walking around, because we've taken that away. All right, we're moving on. And we have our dear friend, Jane Ormerod, who's not far away on Broadway.
Welcome,
Get
Jane.
My regards to Broadway.
Thank you. Thank you, Kat and Peter. First one is from Maintenant. We gathered sea fog because the danger. The cook said, treat your passport as slipper. My great-grandfather read Dickens, displayed his stomach like Gibraltar, had sleigh bells for hire, but whiskey knows when fools and food run out. We gathered fancies, trinkets, banisters for squirrels. Sleep well, good apples, we said, not knowing the dream was dark. Do you like tipsy pudding, she wrote in the card as a New Year's greeting. Yet we draped the family skeleton in noir, ordered room service, and never answered the door. And my second piece is called Catch As People Do. Are you set or art designer, an aspiring assistant? Are you written or directed? The fog continues. I pace as shame pulls close. I think before I sketch, fold, hurdy-gurdy. My house was my friend. This soothing, soothing horse statue, this shadow of a king, magpie, mantel clock, dinner plan, staircase, model of a steamship, construction of a barge, and no one fools the leopard. Watching here, happy here, America watches you sleep. Don't you know how much I love you? It's funny, this dread, the way I may change. I live alone, flee from the understanding of evil. The past is a childhood in an America I did not live. In love with you and fairy tales and a sister as pet. The cheap wedding lasts, aha. A doctor in the snow is nice. A psychiatrist with all the time of urge. And I took the key and looked in your mouth, and America became yet another dead bird in my hand. I cannot help it. Would you like some sherry? You already had tea, and that led to marriage. And when she called me sister, I realized she would then become daughter, and mother would always be on stage. I've never been unhappy. The pull of strangers keeps me out the dance. My mind is not your soul. America, the weather swells. Doctor, I have a ship. Doctor, I have paint. Gumbo or apple pie with your coffee? Goodbye, doctor. I have a hat for the darkness. Shallow, deep, I tread like a scream. Do not tell me I'm charming. Do not threaten me with conscience, my frequency of truth. America said to surround myself with pretty pictures. America, the quack, the kiss, the silence. This is meat pushed beneath the barrier. This is the spot that never changes. A name almost repeated, a county with fine apples, a man with his back turned, a name meant for someone else. Sin clings to the lowest places. My footprint ends at this door. Remember the staircase from the Ambersons, the zoo abandoned by the musical? Is the old world inside or out? A bus is never a bus or a simple bathrobe or T-square. Another song about nothing else to do but warm and living, and zoo becomes garden and the past is body fixed to a smile. Place your hand inside the tree. Happy birthday, darling, Merry Christmas. Let's step out to the veranda and compare the rings on our wedding fingers. I can see her, darling, 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 darling. America, can you see it too?
Thank wow.
You. All right, Jane.
All right, Jane. Armorod.
Fantastic. Whoa. I say no, America cannot see it.
There you go.
But in the pages of MAINTENANT 15, we all see a lot and we all connect that sight and to right. more sight and more inspiration. So here, we're going to move on right now to Yuko Otomo. Please welcome Yuko. Hey.
Hi. Now, before I love. Thank you to you, Peter and Kat, for putting Steve's collage. This is kind of perfect following Jane's poem because United States period piece is about America. Anyway, and, I'm back, my piece and his collage is back and to back. That I really love the idea and I thank you for the layout. Okay, now I'm reading. Actually, I'm really glad he's not here. Can you hear me? Yes? It's too bad he's not here. I'm really curious what he would say. You don't hear? Oh, it's very bad, huh? Let me try, okay? Evolution, methods of healing or breaking the spell. Can you hear? No. No matter what you do, do not ingest any more alpha male physics into the collective unconsciousness or individual egos. The machismos are done. Since the hours of the hunter-gatherer cave dwellers, the spell of building might survival. Throughout history, humanity has been developing the culture of killing. Stop and take a breath. Finally, time has come for the meek to inherit the earth. Switch it from the cult of assaulting and living to the cult of receiving and gratifying. Be gentle every step you're walking on your skin, whether you know it or not. Decompose, deconstruct aftermath of industry.
I think that Yuko dropped off. So
get back on there.
So I'm gonna come back up here. Unfortunately,
I think Yuko dropped out,
and that's technology. So, but she was beautiful in her piece, and
yes, to Steve Dalachinsky.
Steve Dalachinsky is also in this issue.
And
many other issues.
We loved him. We still love him, and we love his work. And also, we lost Jack Hirschman this year. So
So
we have a moment of thought for him and for Steve and for all the others that have gone before to inspire us through this. I wanted to show our piece in the book. Where is it?
There you go.
Okay, so it's you know, we're all fed this bullshit mythology lie that someone would hold up the world for us, or someone got punished to have to hold up the world for us. And sometimes we feel like this person and we apply their pain and their torture to us. And it's like, we have to hold the world up, or we have the Weltschmerz, the weight of the world, a whole mythology built upon our suffering, and definitely from the dominant narrative. So let's move on to restart this thought and say, fuck you! You know what I'm saying? Fuck you with this. We're tired of waiting. And it's W-E-I-G-H-T-I-N-G. We're just tired of, we don't want to restart. We don't want this same mythology. And no matter what we do at this moment, we're going to be back falling and back drafting into the dominant narrative. So let's move forward with all of our narratives, and let's just find inspiration in what we do. But otherwise, don't listen to, you got the way of the world on your shoulders. Everybody does, and everybody always will. So let's move on. Let's share that in the book like we do, and let it come out creatively. So that's what the piece in the book kind of feels at this moment. Maybe it had been a little different. So thank you.
Yeah.
Now, I'm sorry that Yuko dropped out, but if she comes back, maybe
disconnected.
What?
I got disconnected.
Oh, yeah. She's back. Yeah. Where is she?
Okay, I do it later. If you have time, I would do it, but because it's something happened to the machine.
Yeah.
Anyway. It's okay. Go ahead with other people.
Yeah,
I'm okay.
With Martina Salisbury next. So please welcome Martina.
Thank you, Yuko.
Thank you, Yuko.
Martina,
So, hi. Thank you guys so much. Thank you, Peter and Kat, for publishing this beautiful journal and for including my work. And thank you for all, to all the readers so far. I've loved hearing all of your work, especially you, Jane LaCroix. You look great. And I have the poem that's in the book on page 93 to read. It's called Scratching Surfaces of an American Dream. Rumors of remedy recall humanity, long invisible under scars of centuries, blind witness to tears, tattoos on ghost lands, branded across generations, indelible as memory of subterranean synapses, as descendants burned inconvenient truth into drought of redress for seizures, suffering, and amnesia, shapes shifting as new constellations illuminate a path to mourning, not ignoring the darkness, calling it by name. And I have one more. I wasn't sure what I was going to read, but then I heard Heide's, thank you, Heide's music. And that song was in my dream the other morning. And I've never had a Nancy Sinatra song in my dream, but that was in my dream, and this is in my poem, so I thought I'll read this one. Reflections of nocturnal encounters and sidewalk confessions. When the music stopped and distraction disappeared like a Nancy Sinatra song gone wrong, we stood impossibly close as letters were surfacing, as images handwritten and postmarked, non-chronological, making perfect sense in this moment in time as a collection of undefined moments. Recalling our first conversation when you mentioned the letters I knew nothing about, written in the formality of confessions beyond familiar. I imagine one postcard placed in a jacket pocket to be read after workshop, revealing connection of love within parallel solitudes drawing us together like correspondence, telegraphing messages from undisclosed locations, complications of reality allowing only dream encounters and occasional daylight rendezvous.
All right. Thank you, guys. Thank you. Thank you, Martina.
Thank you, Salisbury. Thank you so much.
Hey, how many readers have we got?
We have three more performers with us.
That's right.
Tonight. So you don't have to, you can stop counting. and of course, they're all from MAINTENANT 15, which is why we're here all together for this fine journal that is a journal of contemporary Dada writing and art, which we've done 14 issues of.
Right.
And pretty soon we'll be up to 16. And we will have a theme.
Yes.
Next up is Christine Sloan Stoddard. Please. Yay. Welcome,
Christine.
Thank you, Peter. Thank you, Kat. I'm going to read an excerpt from my piece on page 201, which is a little dramatic piece meant for the stage. It's called Sorry for the Delayed Response to Your Email. So I'll read what amounts to about half of it. Sorry for the delayed response to your email. I just didn't feel like replying. Sorry for the delayed response to your email. I actually won't be sending any more emails to anyone ever again. To reach me, please throw pebbles at my window or do not attempt to contact me at all. Sorry for the delayed response to your email. I don't know if you heard, but email actually doesn't exist anymore. This message was made available via time travel. Your concerns have already been addressed in another dimension. Goodbye. Sorry for the delayed response to your email. Unfortunately, email never existed. It was always a figment of your imagination. You are a sorely disillusioned individual. Hopefully, I am not the first to tell you this. I'm sorry that you imagined email in the first place. What a horrible waste of imagination. You could have had cotton candy teddy bears or even world peace. Instead, you dreamt up email, you soup. Thank you.
A beautiful Yay! Christine Sloan Stoddard.
Christine Very nice. Sloan Thank you. Stoddard. Excellent. All right.
Up on the street too, live in off the streets of Manhattan, I think, or maybe she's in Brooklyn. I couldn't tell.
No, I'm definitely in Soho right now, live from New York City.
All right. Yell up to Jane, wave up to Jane Omerod. She's you might be around Broadway.
All right.
Anyhow, here we are in New York City with the New York Public Library, and we are going to forge ahead with our final two performers and have a little wrap up and. We're so happy. What a show. I mean, how could you fit this much into this short of a time? So
that's right. That's
we certainly have. And it's just sped right along. And let's move on to our next reader. John J. Trous, please. Welcome.
Good evening, everyone. Can you all hear me? Okay. What is Dada? Sparked an epidemic of juvenile obesity among the Albanian diaspora enthusiastic Vortigern, the counterpoise is sanctioned by Saint Collodion of Mayaguez, Stalin lipped. Get it in the house, baby doll. They were uncertain when Zia Marta mentioned junk in the trunk. Not good. I'll crush all your toys. Protesting the marijuanification of New Jersey, teasing treasure chest of Dolly Partonismus, deathbed, Lincoln, diagonal, Fragonard, Bez, Boucher, get me out of here. Thank you. And now for my piece in Maintenant 15. I have an epigraph to that, which I'm going to use a pre-recorded content for, if you'll stay tuned. Hold on a second.
When you're standing on the moon, the world doesn't look so big. Isn't it a beautiful planet? And full of different people and places. It's a pretty ball. Sort of a big blue marble.
Zoom bomb. Abai Haber Yabu Faba covers. Yabu Sabak. Shabadaba. Yabu Haba Baba Sabajurta Shaban Yabe. Shabadaba. Yabu Sabak. Abai Haber Yabu. Faba Yabu. Lava Gabba Yabu. Yabo stubba baba baba chubbies. Yabo obal sabak shabadaba. Yabo shabab hebab shabad hebet. Sabak mabai dabik. Yabo ababasabo. Faba yabo. Thank you. And forgive me.
All right.
You're forgiven.
Oh. That was John J. Trous from over the river.
Yes, he's across the river and through the woods.
Through a couple of rivers, actually.
Really?
Yeah. 8 miles out, yeah.
Okay, eight miles.
Hackensack.
Hackensack right. River, eight miles.
Him and Eminem.
Thanks so much, John J. Trous.
Thank you.
Okay, thanks, Peter.
So we have our final performer for this evening. Welcome, Thomas Walker.
Thomas.
Unmute. I'm unmuted. So from Maintenant, I'm reading Street Prayer. I want to flee from all this insanity. The trickster will jump you and jump on you for nothing. Jesus signed my pardon. Theater is not a mirror to reality, but a hammer to shake it. Find joy in the destruction of the lie. We have the fear of falling, of loud noises, of abandonment. So we learn not to talk. In slavery there is danger. Silence! Speak with silence. We sing of the sorrows, but also of joy. Who are you? From domination and violence, we are the combatants for peace. And then I will read a second poem called There Is a Time. There is a time when black and white will live together. There is a time. There is a time when Arab and Jew will live together. There is a time. There is a time when Jew and Christian will live together. There is a time. When is the time, I ask? There is a time when black juice and Jewish blood and white stuff dissolve, and pain and tears crack up, are held down, but we are now only in the midst of the drama. It is not over, over, not over, over, not over now. Why did the people kill all those in front of, in back of, and all around Esther? Why? Why did the third caliph kill the second caliph, kill the son-in-law? Why? Why did the popes kill the Borgia, Sforza, Sforza, Borgia, Farnese, Medici? Why? I'm sure I know. It's blood feuds. And the very rich of whatever race holding on to power. The fat is in the fire, the rose of Sharon's under glass. The party's on, two Oscars is not enough. Reparations are on the table, Jerusalem is blowing up. Next year, underground. There is a time when it will be worked out, we say. But now we are in the midst of the drama, living together as others are being killed and killing. We can instantaneously communicate that we are late. Global fate. I am a visitor from out of state. There is a time, and it is now, and it is not.
Right, Thomas Walker, beautiful.
Tom Walker, thank you.
Thank you so much for.
All right, what a great way
closing
to
closing us out.
End it.
Okay. Wonderful, wonderful. So now what we're going to do is a little exercise for Dada. The plagiarists are going to lead you, and we're going to unmute everybody.
Back. Get the bikinis.
Everybody on the there we are, and we're going to unmute everybody, and we want everybody to just say Dada.
Just say Dada.
Dada. Dada. Dada. Dada. Dada. Dada. Dada. Dada. Dada. Dada. Dada. Dada. Dada. Dada. Dada. Dada. Dada. Dada. Dada. Dada. Dada. Dada. Dada. Dada. Dada. Dada. Dada. Dada. Dada. Dada. Dada. Dada. Dada. Dada. Dada.
Thank you, Aliana, and the New York Public Library for putting this together, for recognizing that Dada is still a valid force going on.
Thank you all, guys. Thank you.
Yes.
We are the plagiarists. Peter Carlaftes. Tag Georges. We have MAINTENANT 15 with us here. Look for that copy anywhere you like. Yell out to us. Anything. Enjoy. We hope you enjoyed this evening. And thank you so much. Joel, Mark, Robert, Thomas, Joanna, Gordon, John Ness Hall, Bibi, Haida, Ron Combe, Eleni, David, Jane, Elliot, Jane Ormerod, Yuko, Martina, Christine, John J. Trouse, and Thomas Walker. Thank you, everybody.
Thank you, Peter and Kat, for bringing you these amazing people all together. Thank you.
Yes, thank you.
Well, we made 7
YPL.
All right, thank you. Good night.